Hi, this is your girl Wilma, and we're going to be reading in chapter 3 in James. James chapter 3, verse 8 through 10. Okay, and it says, "But no man can tame the tongue. It is an unruly evil, full of deadly poison. With it we bless the Lord and Father, and with it we curse men who are made in the image of God. Out of the same mouth proceed blessing and cursing. My brother, these things ought not to be so." Okay, this is my notes I've been writing about. Okay. Out of the same mouth proceed blessing and cursing. That's what the Bible says, okay? My brother, see, these ought not to be so. We shouldn't do that. We should not be speaking both blessings and curses. We were either going to be to believe one or the other. So make sure you're speaking what you want to come to pass in your life. Now, if something is going wrong in your life, make sure you aren't speaking that problem over and over. It's not that you're denying that problem. Mm-mm. It's just denying its right to come on you as a child of God. It has no right, okay? What we focus on most, what we talk about the most, is what we will become. So make sure you making God and His Word most important thing in your life. Okay? After all, He is bigger, greater, and more stronger than the thing you're facing. Every word, one means something, and it has the power. It has the power itself to come to pass. To make sure you are speaking life, blessings, and good things, set a course of your life by speaking out how you want it to go, okay? God does not want you to speak in both, because He knows that if you do, it can open the door for Satan to come in and bring in that curse to pass. And that doesn't always mean a curse that can end in death. If the first words out of your mouth in the morning is, "I'm so tired," don't be surprised if you spend the rest of the day draggy. Satan will use those words that we see as innocent, and he will bring it to pass. Instead, wake up saying, "I am active and full of energy. My health and energy are increased with each breath I take." And as you do that each and every day, you will find that it will come to pass. Watch your words and make sure you're only speaking positive, faith-filled words, okay? Only speak what you would want to happen. If you don't want to come to pass, remove those words from your vocabulary. Commit and say, "Lord, set a guard over my mouth today. Help me to only speak positive, faith-filled words. Only words that I would want to come pass in my life, in Jesus' name." And I hope you said those words with me. And I'm hoping that I am encouraging you to keep on with faith and believing, and keep on speaking great, wonderful words towards you and your life and your children, your family, your finances, anything that you are in need of. Speak good things to yourself, okay, and your family. And I hope you had your cup of coffee with me today. I know we didn't have much of a Bible verse to keep on drinking coffee, but next time probably I'll have some real big scriptures. You know, some people don't want me to have long scripture reading. And some people want me to have very long scripture reading, but it's hard, you know, to do all the time. All right. We have so much in our life going on, don't we? Always make sure that you have You make the Lord first always in your life. Every morning, make him first. Make him last. Make him in the middle. Make him everywhere. All right, let Jesus come out of your mouth today. In Jesus' name, I hope I see you next time.